Hello, my name is Carly McAvoy, and today we're doing the fourth part of our video series on finding the equation of a line. And I have the important formulas at the top, and also I have written out which kind of problems we solve in each of the videos. Let me move that down a little bit so you can see all of video 5. And I'm not going to read through those, but you're welcome to do that if you're trying to look for a specific thing that you're looking for. You can find it in that video. In that video set, just go into my Emporium Mathematics page and search the videos for Find the Equation of a Line 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. Today we're doing Find the Equation of a Line given the X or Y intercept and another point, and Find the Equation of a Line using information about parallel and perpendicular lines. So if you were given the information like this, the point negative 7, 2 and the X intercept is 2, an ordered pair as an ordered pair, the x-intercept can be written as 2, 0 here, right? Because any x-intercept has a y-coordinate of 0. So I can write that in, and that gives me my point. Now here's my two points, and I'm talking about this as my first point and this is my second point, but those are interchangeable as long as you're consistent throughout the problem. But given this information and my slope formula, I know that y sub 2 is 0, y sub 1 is 2, x sub 2 is 2, and x sub 1 is negative 7. So this is x sub 1, y sub 1, x sub 2, y sub 2. And if I just plug those values in, y sub 2 minus y sub 1 gives me negative 2, and 2 from the x sub 2, 2 minus negative 7 is negative, and a negative makes that plus, so that's 7 plus 2 or 9. So I get negative 2 ninths for my slope. Then I'm going to come over here and plug this into the point slope formula, going through this rather quickly because this is what we did in video 3, was showing you how to find the equation of a line given two points. The only new thing is that they said the x-intercept, which we have to interpret and that into an ordered pair. And then the slope intercept, a point slope equation, we plug in y sub 1, which we said was 2. We plug in x sub 1, which was negative 7. It's the minus minus makes that a plus. And we plug in the slope, which we found over here, we know now is negative 2 ninths. So we have this equation as our point slope form. And then I'm going to distribute that negative 2 ninths to get rid of the parentheses. That's going to give me negative 2 ninths x and negative 14 ninths. And the last step here is to move that 2 to the other side. And so when I do that, I'm going to add 2 to both sides. So I'm just going to get y on the left side. I'm still going to have negative 2 ninths x on the right side. But what do I have on the other side? What I have is negative 14 over 9 that I already had. And what does 2 look like? Positive 2 in ninths is actually 18 ninths, right? Because 18 divided by 9 would be 2. So what I do is I take the 2 and I change it to have a common denominator with my other number in the equation that I want to add it to. And then I can easily see that, well, negative 14 and positive 18 is positive 4. So I'm going to end up with plus 4 ninths. And you can also do that on your calculator if that would be helpful to you. And then before I move on to the next one, what if we were given the y-intercept instead? Well, the y-intercept would have x as the 0 as the x-coordinate with the number given for the y-intercept, or b there. So we would know what b is, which means we'd already know what this part was. And we could find the slope using the point that was given and the ordered pair that we would create as 0, comma, whatever they gave us for the y-intercept. So whether it's x or y, you can just make your x or y-intercept into a point, and then you'll be able to use it. Parallel lines have the same slope, and perpendicular lines have slopes that are negative reciprocals to each other. In parallel lines, you can see the slopes would be exactly the same. Perpendicular lines, if one of the lines has a negative slope, the other one's going to have positive. That's the negative to each other. And then reciprocals means it's flipped. So 2 over 3 becomes 3 over 2. The y-intercepts, that doesn't matter what they are. We decide whether they're parallel or perpendicular based on their slopes. If they had the exact same y-intercept, then it would be a line that would be on top of each other, right? And then neither parallel or perpendicular, 1 half and 2, those are reciprocals, but they're not negative reciprocals to each other. They're just two lines, neither parallel nor perpendicular. Find the slope of the line parallel and perpendicular to the given lines. So if you're given this equation, negative 2x plus y is negative 5, we would first solve for y, and we would do that just by shifting that 2x to the other side. So I'd get y equals 2x minus 5. That would be solving for y, so we can see what the slope is. Now we see the slope is 2. So anything that was parallel to this line would also have a slope of 2. And anything perpendicular to that 2, to that line, would have the reciprocal, which is 1 over 2, but the negative of that, or negative 1 over 2. So that would be the slope of a perpendicular line. Y equals 4. What is the slope of this constant line? This doesn't show you the slope. It just says y equals 4. And so that's the same as saying y equals 0x plus 4, right? We don't show you the 0x because we don't need to do that, but I could do that. And so if when you see it this way, that means you understand that the slope is 0. So any other line that has y equals, I wanted to hit the tab in there to separate those, but not doing very well, so I'll separate it this way. I just wanted to keep them separate a little bit. Anything that is parallel to y equals 4 is going to also have a slope that is 0. But what about the slopes that are perpendicular to that? Well, if our y equals 4 is a horizontal line, then something perpendicular to that is a vertical line. And vertical lines have slopes that are undefined, because a line perpendicular to y equals 4 would be vertical, and all vertical lines have undefined slopes, and horizontal lines have slopes that are 0. If that's something you're having trouble with, you can go back and go into my videos and search for slope of a line parallel, vertical and horizontal. Okay, I want to finish this video up before too much time runs out. Find the slope-intercept equation of a line that is parallel to 2x minus 3y equals 5 and passes through the point negative 3, 4. What's the slope of this line? Well, the slope of this line would be, we would first move the 2x to the other side. So we would get negative 3y equals negative 2x plus 5. And then you would divide everything by negative 3 to get y by itself. And when you divide negative 2 by negative 3, you get 2/3 positive. And then you'd get 5 divided by negative 3 would be negative 5/3. So there's the equation of the line. That means that the slope here would be 2/3. And that means that anything that's parallel to that would also have a slope of 2/3. So we know our slope is 2/3, and we know our point is negative 3, 4, and from there I would plug into the point slope formula, and I would have y minus 4 equals 2/3 x plus 3, right? Because I'm going to say plus because I have a subtraction in the formula and I have a minus there, so two minuses. This is the point slope form, and then we want to find the slope intercept form. We would solve for that until we get it into the correct format. We would be distributing and moving things around. So real quick, we'll do that. Y equals 2/3 x, plus I'm distributing the 2/3 to the 3, which gives me 2, and then add 4 to both sides. Right? I'm adding 4 because I have negative 4 over here. And then that would give me a final answer of y trying to use the equation editor, of y equals 2/3 x plus 6. Okay, so this is the what they asked for was slope-intercept form. And so this is the slope-intercept form that I have here. And how would this change if our line was perpendicular? If our line was perpendicular, the slope to a perpendicular line would have been negative 3/2. And we would have put negative 3/2 in here instead of 2/3. So you just have to read the question and see what you're given. And then finally, find the equation of a line that passes through the point negative 1, 3 and is perpendicular to the given equation. Well, look at your equation here. What is the slope of the given line? If I look closely here, I can see the slope is negative 3. So what's the slope of the line perpendicular to that? Well, the reciprocal of 3 is 1/3. The negative of that would be positive 1/3. So the slope would be 1/3, and then you have a point, and you have the slope, just like we did up here, and you would go back through, plug in, and then simplify. So if you're given a picture, it's the same drill. You know the slope, and then you decide whether it's parallel or perpendicular to that. Okay, that's it for this one, and I hope you have a great day.